Hey everyone, in this video I want to do another design tutorial, and it's for this style right here where things are in a heart, graphics are in a heart. I'm going to show you some of the best practices on how you can do it yourself, where to find graphics, and how to put it together. You can see I've done this with my Draw with Detour graphics, as well as some graphics that I found in Creative Fabrica. I've also seen this pattern in Target. I took this picture right here. I'm gonna show you how to do it. We're gonna go to Creative Fabrica first to find some graphics, but you can find graphics wherever you find graphics. It can go, be on Kiddo or Canva or whatever. And I'm gonna show you how to put it together in Affinity Designer, but again, you can use any graphics design app that you want. You can do this in Canva or Kiddo or wherever you feel most comfortable. I think some of these things are gonna be very basic. So let's go to Creative Fabrica now. I'll show you how to find some graphics and what to look for. So step one is finding graphics. Now you could draw your own with Draw With, like I did with Draw With Detour, or you could use the same graphic over and over again, like we've seen with paws, like dog paws, or you can also do some with hearts. You've seen multiple hearts. But I think the best way to do this, or the most fun way to do this, is to find 6 to 7 graphics that are kind of all in the same style. And the best way to do that is to find a bundle of these. And Creative Fabrica has tons of bundles for different things. Let me show you one that I found here. Of course, you've seen the one that I did with a donut. I did donut bundle, and you can see some of these patterns with hearts and butterflies and things like that. I usually want to do one like a topic that most people, that a lot of people like. So since football is really big right now with the Super Bowl coming up, now this isn't a Super Bowl thing, but it's a football thing. So I'm going to do football bundle. Now here's a lot of football things, but there isn't, like this one right here, this bundle only has like 2 or 3, and then these other ones are outlines, and these kind of could work. So I'm going to scroll down and find one. I'm going to show you one that I would pick. Now this one's kind of good, but again, there's only 7, and we can see right here we only have a football helmet and this football and that football, and they don't really match. So I'm not gonna pick that. This one's okay, but again, there's only 3. I'm looking for like 5 to 7. I'm gonna keep scrolling down here. Maybe I could use that one. You can see there's a bunch. This one would be cool, but again, there's just basically the same football, just turned sideways. Let's see if there's some, okay, this one right here. This one has a lot more. So we got the heart, we got the football, we got all these silhouettes, which is really cool. We can see all of those right there. Hand signs, a football helmet, and everything. So I'm gonna do this one. I already have Creative Fabrica. I subscribe to it, pay subscription for it. You can too. I'll put a link there if you don't have this. Now you don't have to use this one. You don't have to use Creative Fabrica, but what we're looking for is like 5 to 6 graphics that are in the same style, same genre. Now, again, you don't have to do that too, because we've seen one with all the hearts making a heart, or all dog paws making the thing. But I think having it with a variety like this, it can make it stand out and make it harder for someone to copy you, because anybody can do hearts within and a heart and it will kind of look the same. So we want to do something different. So I'm going to download this right here. It's going to download to my downloads folder, and I'm going to open it up in Affinity Designer. Hopefully I can get just the SVGs here and put it all together and just be a vector and be great. Now you can follow along in Canva or Kiddo or whatever you use for this next step. It's going to be pretty basic. I think you can do it in any of them. So let's go to Affinity Designer and I'll show you what to do next. All right, so here I am in Affinity Designer. I got the bundle, I downloaded it. This was what was in the folder. Sometimes it's like this where everything's in different folders. So it took me a while to come in here and open up each one and look for each one, but I found the ones that I needed. I'm not gonna show you how to do that because it's gonna be different for each one depending on your bundle, but you can see I have all the SVGs in here as well as the silhouettes and everything. So the next thing I'm gonna do is take all of these and put it into one file. I'm gonna open up one of my designs, or open up a new file, sorry, in here, new, and I'm gonna do Merch by Amazon size 4500 by 5400, and then I'm gonna drag it all in here. That's gonna take me a little while, but once I do that, one thing that I forgot to say is you wanna look for graphics without an outline. So this is very important, because if you have an outline and then you're scaling things up and down, that outline is gonna be bigger and smaller and it's not gonna match. So you notice a lot of these, or all of these, don't have an outline around them. And I purposely took out the outline for my design that I did with the draw with detour ones. And that's because I don't want the outline to be thinner and some bigger and thicker. So it's better to find these, like these silhouettes or other designs or graphics that don't have an outline around them. So when you're looking for your bundle, make sure you do that. So next thing I'm gonna do is bring them all in here, all those silhouettes, and then I'll show you what to do next. All right, so I'm just about done putting them all in here on one file. Now, let me show you what I did. I came here, got the SUV, grabbed this all. Now, you don't wanna just grab this because they're not grouped. So you wanna make sure that you have the whole thing like this, instead of just grabbing this. You can see that wouldn't be good, right? So I select the whole thing, hit Command G to group it, hit Command C to copy it, come back here and hit Command V, and now it's here. The reason why I wanna open up every SVG separately instead of just dragging all the SVGs in here is that if you do that in Affinity, by default, it's gonna link to the original one and then it's not gonna work as well. So you wanna do that, bring them in separately, and it just works out a lot better. At least that's how I feel like it does. Maybe there's a setting that I need to turn on that makes it better. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come in here and actually draw a heart with the heart tool or heart shape tool. Click on it right there and just drag it and make it as wide as the 4500 by 5400. Now, we're gonna just use this as a guide. So what I like to do is I change the color to none and have this as, it can be black, but just make sure that the stroke is thick enough that you can see it, and that's it. And that, of course, you wanna center it here too. So make sure that's centered. It doesn't have to be centered top, but you could put it at the top. Whoops, you could drag this to the top. I forgot I wasn't on the select tool. Make sure you hit the select tool. I was trying to draw another heart. Drag it to the top here and then make sure that's centered again. Okay, so that's the next step that you wanna do after dragging all your graphics on here, whether in Canva or Kiddo, that actually might be easier. Make sure you draw the heart here and make it so that it's just the background. Now you can lock this down right here if you can find it. I'm gonna have to move it right here. So you can see I have, this is the only thing in my artboard right here, and I can come in here and lock it so that I can't move it anymore so that it's there, and I can unlock it and delete it later. All right, so let's start moving things in. Another best practice is if you find something that's kind of left or right, I would put it on the left or right of the heart. So for example, this one right here makes perfect sense to be on this side, right? Because it kind of has this feeling right here where it's rounded on that side. Now you're gonna have to decide how big you wanna make your graphics next of all. Since we have this many graphics, I would suggest, and it's a lot easier the smaller graphics you use, because if you use the big graphics, then they almost have to fit perfectly like a puzzle, but it makes it easier if you have your graphics smaller here. So hold down shift to make sure that it scales proportionately, because if not, you're gonna do this kind of thing. So hold down shift here, and I would probably make it like that big, right? And we're gonna fill the space, the little spaces, with other things, but right now we're gonna try it and use as many images as we can, turning them and things like that. So let's see if there's one that would go great on this side. This one's kind of rounded that way. This one as well. We could also flip these, right? Like if this one was this way, or if we see something like this one on this way, we can come in here and we can flip it, and now it works on this side, right? So let's come back in here and hold down shift again. Oh, this one's grouped, so I don't need to shift it. If it was grouped, you can see, because that was a separate ball there. I don't need to. So come in here, looks like that would fit right there, about the same thing. So we're gonna, I'm not gonna show you how to do this in real time, but I'm gonna speed up the video so you can see where I'm putting everything, so this video doesn't take an hour. And then I'm gonna come back and show you how to fill the other spaces after I put the majority of these in here. We don't have to use all of them, but I'm gonna make sure that I use at least 10 of them to start and see where I am from there. All right, so I'm at a good spot here. You notice that I put some footballs and hearts in here and put them all in here. One of the things that I like to do is make sure that I get to right to the edge. So if I can use the football to get to the edge of here, I think that kind of helps. You can see it doesn't have to be perfect, but it's nice to kind of make sure that it gets close to it, because it doesn't have to be, as long as when you take away this heart, that it still looks like a heart shape. Now, some of the tricks that I like to do too is kind of turn the football in different ways, or the things that I'm using over and over again. So you can see this one's turning that way, but that one turns that way, and so on. Like this one, maybe I would want to turn this way because that one has this on that side. So that's some of the tricks that I do. Now, to fill in the space, since it's Valentine's, I'm just going to use hearts again, not these hearts, but I'm going to go back and draw a heart like this. And I'm going to fill this black here, and I'm going to use that to kind of fill in the little spaces in here. So if I got this right here, I can come in here and add to it right here, trying to get to the edge again, and just trying to fill any of the little spaces here that makes sense. So I'm going to do that for a little while and show you what happens when that's all filled in. All right, so I think that's good. I think that looks great. And now I'm gonna go and remove that heart. So I'm gonna come back in here, and it's gonna be on the bottom layer, right? This heart right here that I locked. I'm gonna unlock it, and I can actually just toggle this off like this so you can't see it. And you can see it's nice, it's still that heart shape. And I'm gonna color it in different colors. So first, I'm gonna select all of these, and then I'm going to make sure that it's all the same color with red. I'm just using 100-100, maybe a little darker with the K. I like 100-120 or 0-100-120 there. That would look great on a white t-shirt. Now I'm going to reverse it to white. So let's assume that this is a red background. So I'm going to click the background and do that, and so that you can see it, and select all of these again, and then make this white. So there you go, a heart-shaped one right there. And if you want to export it, it's really easy from here. So make sure that the background is transparent, no set, no fill, and I'm going to just hit Command Option Shift S right here, and make sure it's selection only. You can see it's 4500 by 5400, and export, and I would call this football heart red. You can call it whatever you want, it's the PNG. And then of course I can save this one. Again, make sure that the transparent background, of course you can't see it, but it's there. Command Shift Option S, and you can see the white right here, and I'm gonna export this one as football heart white, like that. Save, and there you go. And I like to put the background on there, and you can see I didn't use these, so I'm just going to get rid of these right here just to clean it up. And there you go. So that's how I did that one. Of course you can do it with any graphics, but I think this will help, or it makes it different than what everybody else is doing, which could be hearts or other things. I think this one could do really well for people who love football, and it's around Valentine's Day too, so they could wear this on game day or things like that, right? Where it's near football, it just says I love football with graphics, right? And you could put words in here too if you wanted to, or other things, but I think this is a really quick way that you can stand out and create something that's not out there by combining different things, popular things, with a heart. So in this case, football, but if you did video games or coffee or other things, I think that this could really turn out well. So there you go, that was a quick tutorial on how to do this heart shape design and putting different graphics into heart shapes. Hopefully you can follow some of these best practices. Remember to find graphics without outlines. Remember to find graphic bundles that have like 5 to 7 or more. And in this case, I had a lot more to use. So the more that you have, the better chances that you'll find something that will fit. And then fill in the spaces, in this case with hearts. You can also use dots and things like that after you've filled it as much as you can. I didn't say that you don't want anything touching. So if you notice that, I would scale things down so that the graphics don't touch each other. You kind of want some space in between. So those are all the tips. Hopefully yours turns out great. Let me know in the comments if you've done this, I've tried it, and hopefully you can get some sales this Valentine's Day with something very unique that can stand out and hopefully get you sales again and again, year after year with Valentine's. Thanks again for watching. If you want to see another design tutorial, I'll put my latest one right here so you can follow along with this. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.